An old destructive volcano formed the spectacular beauty known as Yellowstone. According to experts, this Yellowstone is not dead. It is only sleeping and progressing down a dangerous route for the future. What is Yellowstone anyway? And what are these dangerous activities detected under this Yellowstone volcanic hotspot? Watch this video until the end to find out. Wyoming, a state in the West, is home to the Yellowstone National Park. It is referred to as one of the strangest places in the world. Why? It is an area where the ground erupts with extremely hot water in numerous locations. Visitors can observe bubbles rising through the hot, boiling dirt. They can make out liquid-like rocks that have irregular forms due to cooling. In the past, Yellowstone has frequently conjured up images of terrifying wonders that early explorers would refer to as weird and marvelous. Thanks to features like Damon's Cave, Devil's Gate, Coffin Spring, and the Black Dragon's Cauldron and Skeleton Pool, it typically leaves a scary impression. The interesting reality, though, is that Yellowstone was constructed atop an old volcano. The park is just 6 kilometers above a lake of hot, liquid rock. Isn't that crazy? According to experts, this lake is under tremendous pressure. At Yellowstone, the heat and pressure can cause mud to boil and hot water to burst out of the earth, which does sound an alarm. Now, supervolcano is a term frequently used to describe the Yellowstone volcano. This phrase is used when a volcano that is exceptionally huge has the potential to erupt with significant impacts on the planet's ecosystem and climate. According to scientists, the Yellowstone region first witnessed profound volcanic activity some 2 million years ago. As a result of this activity, violent explosions and mountains and valleys were formed. According to experts, this supervolcano experienced 3 significant eruptions. These 3 eruptions may have been the most powerful in recorded history for each of them. And during each of these eruptions, millions of tons of rock and ash were released. Due to the size of the most recent eruption, much of North America was covered in ash. Strong winds carried some of this ash high into the skies and around the globe. The cloud of volcanic ash repeatedly encircled the planet. It affected the temperature by reducing the amount of sunlight that reached the Earth's lowest atmosphere and surface. The lava flow, or hydrothermal explosion, which spews rock into the air, are the 2 explosive events that are most likely to happen at Yellowstone now. How do the geysers and hot springs in Yellowstone relate to volcanism, you may ask? Let's dig a little deeper into the science. Yellowstone's magma chamber is surrounded by broken rocks that are filled with dense, salty water. As the magma slowly cools, heat and volcanic gases rise and warm the water. In turn, that brine distributes its heat to the fresh groundwater above it, which is refilled by surface precipitation and snowmelt. The temperature of boiling water occurs at a greater depth than it does at the surface. If it rises swiftly, this superheated water may flash to steam, erupting as a geyser of steam and hot water. More often than not, hot water rises and slowly loses heat, rising to the surface as a hot spring. Now you might wonder how scientists are aware of what is occurring in the underground of Yellowstone, and whether or not Yellowstone was kept an eye on for volcanic activity. For indications of volcanic activity, the Yellowstone volcano is indeed watched. A collaboration between the U.S. Geological Survey, Yellowstone National Park, the Universities of Utah and Wyoming, the Montana Bureau of Mines and Geology, the Idaho Geological Survey, and the Wyoming State Geological Survey has resulted in the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory. In addition to providing real-time data for earthquakes, ground movement, stream flow, and specific stream temperatures, YVO closely monitors volcanic activity in the Yellowstone. Additionally, YVO researchers work with researchers from other countries to examine the Yellowstone volcano. How long in advance could scientists foresee a Yellowstone volcanic eruption? Over the past 25 years, there has been a tremendous advancement in the science of predicting volcanic eruptions. The majority of scientists believe that it would take weeks, possibly months, or even years to notice the buildup before a catastrophic eruption. Intense earthquakes, swarms, and quick ground movement are common precursors of volcanic eruptions, typically occurring days to weeks before the eruption. Researchers at the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory keep a close eye out for such precursors in the Yellowstone region. They anticipate that there will be several locations within the Yellowstone volcano where significant precursory activity, considerably above background levels, will occur prior to more giant eruptions. Minor earthquakes, ground uplift and subsidence, and gas emissions are all common in caldera systems around the world. What would happen if volcano experienced another supervolcano eruption? The impacts of another big caldera-forming eruption of Yellowstone would be felt worldwide. Regional repercussions of such a large eruption would include falling ash and short-term, roughly decades to years of changes in the climate. Pyroclastic flows would have an impact on Yellowstone's immediate surroundings in the states of Montana, Idaho, and Wyoming, while falling ash would have an impact farther in the United States. Withdrawal of partially molten rock called magma from below causes the ground surface to collapse during such eruptions, creating calderas, which are large volcanic depressions. Fortunately, the likelihood of this type of eruption at Yellowstone in the coming few thousand years is extremely low. Now, how can we prevent this disastrous eruption from occurring? Can you drill into it? Drilling to minimize a volcanic threat is very different, with unknown outcomes, enormous expenditures, and severe environmental implications. However, restricted scientific drilling for research can occasionally help us comprehend magmatic and hydrothermal systems. Drilling through hot, mushy rock is costly and technically challenging, and it is unlikely to impact whatever magma is stored under Yellowstone. Any hole would quickly become shut by minerals crystallizing from the natural fluids that are present at those depths at temperatures and pressures that are nearly magmatic. In addition, geothermal resource development is prohibited within the Yellowstone National Park. Old Faithful Geyser and Grand Prismatic Spring are two well-known phenomena that rely on heat from the magma chamber under Yellowstone's surface. Any proper geothermal extraction would relieve pressure on the already active geysers and hot springs, changing their behavior, in many cases, making them vanish. There have been concerns about volcanic eruptions at Yellowstone in the past, but it is unknown whether such eruptions will ever take place there again. The magma reservoir's most recent seismic imaging suggests a system that is too crystalline to erupt on a larger scale. Even if Yellowstone had a substantial chunk of eruptive magma, drilling into it in an effort to relieve pressure would be disastrous. Depressurization is one of the mechanisms that can cause magma to rise to the surface and erupt, as a scientific investigation has repeatedly shown. Therefore, efforts to cool and depressurize magma systems would have many unforeseen detrimental effects, including increasing the likelihood of an eruption. At Yellowstone or elsewhere, a large-scale magma quenching effort won't be started anytime soon. And now for the big question: when will the Yellowstone erupt? Volcanoes do not function in predictable ways, and they do not have predictable eruption cycles. However, the volcano is not overdue for an eruption based on mathematical calculations. Yellowstone has had three significant eruptions, as mentioned before, which were 2.08, 1.3, and 0.631 million years ago. This translates to an average interval between eruptions of around 725,000 years. Accordingly, there is still roughly 100,000 years to go, but this estimate is worthless because it is based on the average of merely two time periods between eruptions. Most volcanic systems that experience super eruptions do not do so repeatedly. If a volcanic system experiences multiple super eruptions, they are not always spaced out equally in time. Scientists do not believe that Yellowstone will ever experience another catastrophic eruption, but it is believed that Yellowstone represents some danger to the public, always has been. It is uncertain if there is even enough magma beneath the caldera to support an eruption, because the rhyolite magma chamber beneath Yellowstone is only 5 to 15% liquid. However, the huge sleeping volcano that lies beneath the Yellowstone National Park also contributes to its natural splendor, making it a treasure that would not be possible otherwise. The jury is still out on whether Yellowstone eruption can cause a catastrophic effect or minor lava flow. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. That was all for this video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more such content. Push the bell icon to never miss an update from us.